गाइस एम आई ऑडिबल? हेलो हेलो। ओके
यस
ओके, वाज इन गोइंग ऑन फॉर अ व्हाइल। नाउ लेट्स बिगिन। ओके, सो टुडे वी विल बी डूइंग डेफिनेट इंटीग्रेशन। All right. So let's just start with a small question actually. Dx by 1 plus e power x 0 to infinity. What does this come out to? You know how to do definite integration, right? How to apply the limits? You integrate, find the indefinite integration version, and then put the limits here.
Sir, what is e power infinities?
Infinity.
Okay.
It will be a huge value. But how did you differentiate this? And then how did you integrate this? Sorry.
No, sir. I was just thinking like in putting that formula f of a equal to f of a minus x. And that f of x equal to f of a plus b minus x.
Okay, but then it's infinity minus x and all, right? So it will be unnecessarily complicated. Don't use that. We haven't reached properties yet. This is the standard integration. So multiply numerator and denominator by e power minus x. So it becomes e power minus x plus 1. Now you take this as t. E power minus x plus 1 is equal to t. And then differentiate, what do you get? Minus e power minus x dx equal to dt. You almost have dt here. So this becomes minus dt by t. Okay. So when x is equal to 0, t is equal to e power 0 is 1, t is equal to 2. When x is equal to infinity, e power minus infinity becomes 0 plus 1 is 1. Okay. So this can be written as 1 to 2 dt by t. Is this much clear? I remove the minus sign by changing the order of the limits.
So how did we get 2 to 1 and 1 to 2?
So look, here in the question, x is going from 0 to t. Okay. So when x is equal to 0, e power minus 0 plus 1 is t, right? E power minus 0 is e power 0, which is 1. So t is equal to 1 plus 1, which is 2. When x is equal to 0. Next, you are putting x equal to infinity. That's the next value. So when you say e power minus infinity plus 1 is t, what is e power minus infinity? 1 by e power infinity, which is 1 by infinity, which is 0. So t is equal to 1 there. So when you put x equal to 0, t is equal to 2. And when you put x equal to infinity, t is equal to 1.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right, that's substitution we use. When you brought in the new variable, how does the variable change? And this minus sign, you understood how it got replaced?
Yes, sir.
So log 2 is the answer, no, sir?
Log 2 should be the answer. Let's see. So this becomes log of 2 minus log of 1. Okay, this is basically log of t. Okay, you get the answer here. And then it becomes log of 2 minus log of 1. Log of 1 is 0. Log 2 is the answer. Yes, yes. Okay, let's move on. Guys, any doubts here, both of you?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
Okay, log x dx. Delete this. Okay, so what do you do here? X log x minus x is the formula when you integrate this. We did it before. So this becomes 2 log 2 minus 2 minus 1 log 1, which is 0, minus 1. This becomes 2 log 2 minus 1. This becomes your answer. Okay. Right. Now, okay, let's do properties. Properties of definite integration. Okay, first one. From A to B, f of x dx is A to B, f of z dz. Basically, you introduced x equal to z. You just changed the name of the variable. That's all you did. Okay, you get the same answer. Okay, understood? If x is equal to z, when x is equal to A, what is the value of z? Z is A. And x is equal to B. What is the value of z? Z is also B because x is equal to z. Just change the name of the variable. It still remains the same. Okay. It is unnecessarily obvious that is there for the first property. But yeah. Continue from this. From A to B, it'll be minus B to A f of x dx. We just demonstrated that right now. Right? If you're integrating any f of x from A to B, you can write that as like some function in terms of x you'll get, which you take from A to B, right? And so you write that as f of B minus f of A. This is what happens when you integrate, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here, what happens when you change the sign here? As in when you go from B to A, it becomes f of A minus f of B, which is negative of this. That's why they are the negatives of each other. Then, we have the third property, A to B, f of x dx is equal to, so you have this range from A to B. Okay, so between them, you'll break it into different parts, C1, C2, all the way up till Cn. So, this becomes a to c1 of x dx plus c1 to c2 of x dx plus c2 to c3 plus the last one, cn minus 1 to cn f of x dx. No, this is the second last one. Plus cn to b f of x dx. Understood here? You broke it into small parts. You broke the function wherever you could and then added them up. Understood? So this is useful when the definition of the function changes at particular points between a and b. Okay. So then you can just break it down into many parts and treat it accordingly. Yeah. When you integrate, what do you get, guys? You get the area under the curve, right? Basically, above the x-axis. Alright. So suppose you have some function like this. And you want to integrate from here till here. How do you do it? So you can see from here till here, it's one function. Okay, we'll keep it as it is. Okay. So break it at the point C1. And here to here is another function. You break it at the point C2. So this function, okay, f of x dx from A to C1 is this area. And this one is f of x, depending on the type of function it is. Like f of x will have a function, like it'll have a definition. It'll change at different points. So at each different point, it'll be a different function. Not each different point, between different points, it'll be different functions. So you treat it accordingly. Understood? You can bring its third variant from C2 to B. Okay, this is how you find the area. Got this, guys?
Yes, sir.
Varun, any doubts here?
No, no doubts.
Okay, this is called piecewise property. All right. Piecewise property. Okay. So, this is very useful when you are integrating mod function, and then integrating JIF function, integrating square root function, and when you are integrating some explicit changes. Okay, that's what I was talking about here. Okay. So please try to integrate this 0 to 2 x square plus 2x minus 3 dx. Okay, so how is this graph drawn actually? X squared plus 2x minus 3 as it is. It becomes x plus 3 into x minus 1, right? So the graph of that will have roots at minus 3 and plus 1. Minus 3 and plus 1. X plus 3 into x minus 1 will look like this. But we have mod of x squared x plus 3 into x minus 1. So mod of that, the positive part remains positive.
Where is the answer 4?
Huh? What? Is the answer 4? Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Okay. So here the positive part remains positive and the negative part becomes positive. Understood? It becomes correspondingly positive. So the function definition actually changes. All right. From 0 to 2, what are we looking at? So from you can see that from 0 to 1, it behaves like this. From 0 to 2, it behaves like this. Okay. So 0 to 1, you have the negative version of it. So it becomes minus x square minus 2x plus 3dx plus 1 to 2 x square plus 2x minus 3dx. Okay. So this becomes minus x cubed by 3 minus x square plus 3x from 0 to 1 plus again x cubed by 3 plus x square minus 3x from 1 to 2. Further, this becomes 1 by 3 minus 1 plus 3 plus 8 by 3 plus 4 minus 6 minus 1 by 3 minus 1 plus 3. Okay. So, 1 by 3 minus 1 by 3, how convenient, cancel off. Then, I'm left with 8 by 3 here. Is there any calculation mistake, guys? This is minus 2. This is plus 6. Together, they become plus 4. Plus 4 plus 4 is plus 8. Plus 4 plus 4 is plus 8. Plus 8 minus 6 is plus 2. Something's off, right? That's 2x minus 3. So 2 becomes 8, 4 minus 6. Oh, this is minus 1 by 3. Okay, minus 1 by 3 and minus 1 by 3 is minus 2 by 3. Minus 2 by 3 and this becomes 6 by 3, which is 2. Yes. Get the answer as 4 here. Okay. Lakshani, any doubts here?
No, sir.
Okay. All right, quickly do this. Cos x minus sin x dx from 0 to pi. We have to draw cos x and sin x from 0 to pi to understand what I'm saying here. Okay, cos x goes like this from 0 to minus 1. Sin x goes like this. Okay. It becomes 0, it hits the value 1. Yeah, man. Here it becomes 0. Sin x goes like this. Okay, guys. Cos x goes like this and sin x goes like this. You can see that they intersect at a point. You're looking at the difference between cos x and sin x. Here it'll be positive, but here it'll be negative. Okay, here onwards. Understood? When I do cos x minus sin x, here it's positive, here it's negative. The definition actually changes. When is it positive? From 0 to pi by 4. So there it becomes cos x minus sin x. Okay, and then pi by 4 to pi. What does it become? It becomes sin x minus cos x. Because you can see that sin x is greater than cos x for those parts. You can integrate. You can integrate this separately, right? Okay. Manageable. Pi by 4 to pi, sorry. You can, right? Let's not do that right now is what I'm suggesting. But did you understand the process here?
Yes.
Okay. Now, integrating 0 to 1.5. Square plus 1. Come on, quickly do this. What does this become? GIF of x square plus 1. There is integral function. break it down into many parts, right? 0 to 1 into diff of x square plus 1 dx. Basically, x square plus 1. Okay. X takes 0, x square plus 1 at x equal to 0. This becomes 1. So, next integer, when does it happen? X square plus 1. So, check when x square plus 1 is equal to 2. That is when x square is equal to 1. That is at x equal to 1. Next, x square plus 1. Next integer will be 3. Okay. So, that will happen at x square equal to 2. Or in other words, x is equal to root 2. Root 2 is less than 1.5. So, we have to still continue. X square plus 1 equal to 4. That's the next integer. So, that happens at x equal to root 3. But this is greater than 1.5. So, here we stop considering it. Okay. So, these are the number of parts I break it into. 0 to 1. 1 to root 2 and root 2 to the final value 1.5. Okay. So 0 to 1 plus 1 to root 2. The same thing plus root 2 to 1.5. 0 to 1, what is the GIF? Okay, that is the interesting part here, guys. This problem becomes much simpler once you break it down into parts. That's the idea. From 0 to 1, what does this integral become? X square plus 1 is point something, right? Oh, sorry. 1 point something, right? Right, guys? From when x takes the value 0 to 1, x square plus 1 becomes 1 point something. Agreed?
Yes.
Okay, so GIF of that is 1. Okay, so when this goes from 1 to root 2. X square plus 1 takes a value 2 point something. You can see between 1 to root 2, it goes between 2 and 3, x square plus 1. So, it will take some value 2 point something. So, you're looking at GIF of that is 2. So this is 2dx plus root 2 to 1.5. It becomes 3dx. I don't think I need to explain this part. Then it becomes x into 1 minus 0, which is 1. It's 2x into root 2 minus 1. Root 2 minus 1. Plus 3 into 1.5 minus root 2. This becomes 1 minus 2 plus 9 by 2. Plus 2 root 2 minus 3 root 2 is simply minus root 2. This is minus 1 plus 4.5. With 10 by 2 minus root 2. And your final answer. Understood the concept here? How to deal with such problems?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 1 to 2. Fractional part of x dx. How do you do such functions? You don't have any direct formula. You only have the graph of fractional part of x. It goes like this, right? From 0 to 1. This is a fractional part of x graph. You're going from 1 to 2. So, x is going from 1 till 2. So, okay. We'll take from 0 to 2. Sorry. We'll take from 0 to 2. So, then what are we trying to find? We're trying to find this area as well as this area. Right, guys? So, if you know the graph, you can directly say 2 into half base into height. 1 becomes your answer. Okay. Classically, how would you solve it? Which steps? This is the graph, y equal to x. This is the graph, y equal to x minus 1. How do you find the area under this graph? From 0 to 1, you're looking at x dx. From 1 to 2, you're looking at x minus 1 dx. If I take x minus 1 as t, what does this become? So then dx is dt. This is t dt. But when x is equal to 1, what happens to t? T becomes 0 when x is equal to 1. When x is equal to 2, t becomes 1. So basically, from 0 to 1, we're integrating t dt. Basically, we're integrating the same thing twice. You can write this as 2 into 0 to 1 dx. This 2 into x square by 2. Your final answer here is 1 again. Got this, guys? Got all the methods I just said right now?
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, let's give you a couple of problems for practice. Please practice them. 1 to 2.
Sir, can you scroll up 1 second?
Yes. Here?
Yes, I got it.
Okay, these are your practice questions. Please do them later. Okay. Now, fourth property. 0 to a f of x dx equal to 0 to a f of a minus x dx. Okay, like if you take f of a minus x dx 0 to a, take a minus x as t, what does this become? When x is equal to 0, t is equal to a. When x is equal to a, t is equal to 0, f of t. And then you know that minus dx is dt. This becomes minus dt. So this can be written as 0 to a f of t dt, or if you change the name of the variable, it becomes f of x dx. Understood, guys? Right. So when I say f of x dx from a 0 to a, what is happening here from 0 to a? I am finding this area. But what about f of a minus x? How will that function look? So when x is equal to 0, you're looking at f of a, which was this value. When x is equal to something like this, it'll be somewhere here. It'll be the exact opposite of that one. Understood? So you can say that the area under them will be the same. Got this? Do you understand the figure here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then next property, a to b of x dx can be written as a to b f of a plus b minus x dx. It's the same idea, but instead of 0 to a, we are going from any a to b. Okay, so between a to b, there is some f of x. Okay, f of a plus b minus x will simply be like this, the mirror image of that. Okay, f of a plus b minus x will simply be the mirror image of that. Just check. When you put x equal to a, what happens here? This becomes f of b. Okay, so this value comes here. When you put x equal to b, what happens? This becomes f of a. Okay, that's how the graph goes like this. Even at any point in between, it'll be true. All right. Please do this question. 0 to pi by 2 log tan x dx. So you can say that this is equivalent to 0 to pi by 2 log of a plus b minus x. Okay, that's the generic form. Log of 0 plus pi by 2 minus log tan of 0 plus pi by 2 minus x. So it becomes tan of pi by 2 minus x. What is tan of pi by 2 minus x? It is cot x. These both are the same. I will call them I. Let's add both of them. This is an important technique, guys. You add both of them. What do you get? 0 to pi by 2 log tan x plus log cot x, which becomes log tan x into cot x dx. You got log tan x plus log cot x. Log a plus log b is log a b. Okay, so you get log tan x cot x. It becomes 0 pi by 2 log of 1. And log 1 is 0. So this comes out to 0. Not this. Instead of doing indefinite integration and then finding the final answer, which is close to impossible here, this is what you do. This is why this technique is very useful. Notice the limits and then play with them. Okay, guys. Should I give you another question? No, it's okay. I will. Root of sine power 7x divided by root of sine power 7x plus root of cos power 7x dx. Quickly tell me the answer. This answer will be? We'll call this I. This will also be from 0 to pi by 2. Replace x with 0 plus pi by 2 minus x, which is pi by 2 minus x. So sine pi by 2 minus x becomes cos x. The numerator becomes cos power 7x. Denominator becomes similarly cos power 7x plus sine power 7x. Add both of them up. What do you get? 2i. This is the standard technique, guys. 2 pi. 2i is 0 to pi by 2. Numerator and denominator become the same when you add both of them up. You get it as 1. You can say that I is pi by 4. Got this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'll give you some practice questions later. 0 to pi by 4 log 1 plus tan x dx, 0 to pi by 2 log sin x minus log sin 2x dx, 0 to pi gif of cot x dx. Then cot inverse 1 minus x plus x square from 0 to 1 dx. Okay, noted the questions down?
Yes, sir.
We're moving on to the next property. Minus a to a f of x dx. Okay. So this is for odd function, even function. Okay, that is that property. When it's an odd function, you get 0. What is an odd function? F of x is equal to minus of f of minus x. Okay. Or f of minus x is equal to minus f of x. Okay, that's the better definition here. F of minus x is minus of f of x. This will be 2 into 0 to a of x dx if it is even function, which means f of minus x is equal to f of x. You know what odd functions and even functions are, right? So odd function, if it goes like this in the first quadrant, it will be going correspondingly like this in the third quadrant. This is an odd function. Even function, if it goes like this in the first quadrant, it will be mirror image in the second quadrant. Okay, this is an even function. The idea is, if I integrate from minus a to plus a for an odd function, what happens to the area? This is a negative area. This is a positive area. They simply cancel each other out, right? That's why you get 0 for an odd function if the limits are symmetric about the origin. If it is an even function, what happens? You just need to calculate one side and then multiply that by 2. Okay. Going from a to minus a, you just need to calculate 1, basically 0 to a, and multiply that by 2. Clear? Okay, guys. Minus half of cos x log 1 plus x by 1 minus x dx. What happened here? Is this an odd function or an even function? Is we have this as f of x. Okay. What about f of minus x? What will happen here? It becomes cos of minus x into log 1 minus x by 1 plus x. Cos of minus x is cos x. Same thing. But this changes here. Log of 1 minus x by 1 plus x. If I put a minus sign outside, it becomes log of 1 plus x by 1 minus x. Reciprocal. If you're taking the reciprocal inside, it'll become, you'll take a minus outside. Raised to minus 1. Think about it like that. So you can see that this is clearly an odd function and you're looking at values between minus half and half directly, right? Zero. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you get any odd functions. Okay. So look at, watch out for the limits. When you see odd functions, play well with them. Now, let's move to another property. This is actually a pretty good property. Minus a to a f of x dx for any function, odd, even, or neither. Okay. 0 to a f of x plus f of minus x. You have some random function like this and you're trying to integrate from minus a to a. Okay. So basically you'll break it into two parts. One is 0 to a f of x. The other is minus a to a f of x. Right? This minus a to 0. Okay. These are two parts you break this into. Okay. Now, this minus a to 0 f of x dx, I replace x with minus t. What happens here? This becomes f of minus t. This becomes minus dt. The minus of minus a to 0. Okay, sorry. So when x is equal to minus a, t will be equal to plus a. That changes. Now this minus sign is there. To take care of that, I'll write it plus 0 to a. Okay, this becomes this. F of minus x dx. Just change the name of the variable. Understood? So suppose you're in a position where you can't find the integral from minus a to a, or and you can only find from 0 to a. This is how you can use it. Okay, find this piece. Come on. Minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. This can be written as minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. 1 by pi by 2 minus pi by 2 minus x. That is what you replace x with. Then this becomes e power minus sin x plus 1, which can be written as minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, 1 plus e power sin x, and on top you have e power sin x as well. Okay, add this and this, you'll get it cancelled out to 1. Okay, the answer is I. So then adding this and this, you get 2i equal to 1, which you're integrating from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, which is nothing but pi. Okay, so here you can say that I is equal to pi by 2. Now this,
yes, sir.
Yeah. So another variation of that property. Maybe 0 to 2a of x dx is 2 integral 0 to a f of x dx or 0. This is if f of 2a minus x equal to f of x, and this is if f of 2a minus x equal to minus of f of x. So here, what is happening here is that you are describing two cases. 0 to 2a f of x. Okay, so 0 is here, assume 2a to be here, and assume a to be here. Let's look at the first case. F of 2a minus x equal to f of x. What does that mean? So if I take x equal to 0, f of 2a is equal to f of x. So okay, suppose f of 0 is here, then f of 2a should also be here. If you take, instead of a, you take a by 2, what does this become? F of 3a by 2 equal to f of a by 2. So suppose f of 3a by 2 was here, sorry, 3a by 2 or f of a by 2 was here, it should be at the same level. So basically, you're talking about a function that is, that acts like an even function about x equal to a line. Okay. All right. Understanding. So this is like an even function only. You can see this definition here, right? In this property. This looks like this function is even function. This looks like this was an odd function. But even function, if this was going from minus a to a, and odd function, same thing. If this was going from minus a to a, okay, had this been from minus a to a, that was the previous property. Here, we are just shifting it to 0 to 2a. Okay, so we are looking at the midpoint of 0 and 2a, which is a. So if it is odd about that point, in the sense, if I get something like this, then on this side, it should be like this. Okay. F of 2a minus x is minus of f of x. Okay. So you can see that the area here is clearly 0. Right? Okay, these are the two cases being discussed here. Okay. Did you write this down, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, please solve this. Okay. Prove that 0 to pi by 2 log sine x dx equal to 0 to pi by 2 log cos x dx equal to minus pi by 2 log 2. Using that first property, a plus b minus x property, you can prove the first two parts, right? You can replace sine x with sine of 0 plus pi by 2 minus x, which is nothing but cos x. So the first part proof is easy, but find their value. That is interesting part. Come on. Okay, what do you do here? You call this I. You call this I. What is 2i? It's a very important technique, guys. This becomes 0 to pi by 2 log of sin x cos x dx. Now, if it was 2 sin x cos x, what would it become? It will become sin 2x, right? So, I will write this as 0 to pi by 2 log of sin 2x. But then there should be log 2 here. Like, okay. So, here I'll be basically adding log 2 and subtracting log 2. This log 2 will attach to this and become sin 2x. Okay. And then there's the remaining minus log 2 dx. This one is okay? Okay. Now, take 2x as t. What happens now? I becomes, so when x is 0, t is also 0. When x is pi by 2, t is pi. You get log sin t minus log 2 dx. All right. So what is I here? It will be half of this, right?
Yes, sir.
So the is of 0 to pi log sin t minus of log 2 dt. 2x is t, then wait 1 second. I'm changing it to dt, right?
Sir, so, you have to separate the log 2.
Come again?
Sir, can you separate the log 2?
Yeah, I'm separating it. I'm separating it. So 2 dx is dt. So dt will be, so dx will be dt by 2. Okay, so it will be 1 by 2 here. All right. So this becomes, yeah, what do you say? You have to separate the log 2 term. Varun?
Yes.
What did you say? I didn't hear you properly.
Not that, sir. I just said that you had to separate the log 2 term. Like, it's not necessary to keep it together in that same integral.
Yes. So, I separated out. And what does this become? It simply becomes pi by 2. Log 90 minus pi by 2 log 2, right?
Then we can apply the property, because then sine of 2 pi minus x, 2 pi minus t is equal to sine t.
Sine of pi minus t is equal to sine t. Okay, not 2 pi. Okay? Okay, sine of pi minus t is equal to sine t. Nicely done. Okay. So this becomes half of. So what is this? What happens to this integral? So log of sine t is there. Okay. It's not minus sine. Sine goes like this from 0 to pi. So it acts like an even function around pi by 2. Right. So log of sine will also act like an even function around pi by 2. Okay. So this is where you play it smart. And I did as 0 to pi by 2 into 2. Log sin t dt minus pi by 2 log 2. 2 and 2 will cancel out. What is this here? This is nothing but I. Okay. Okay, minus pi by 2 log 2. So you get I equal to minus pi by 2 log 2 here. Actually, yeah, you've been keeping quiet for a while. Are you following?
Yes, I am following.
Okay. Varun said, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. Try this question. Minus 1 to 1. X square. B ln x. How do you take care of this?
we have to differentiate ln x.
To differentiate ln x. So what does that become? Dx by x, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And what about this one? How do you further take care of this? It becomes x square by 2, right? X and x square cancel out, you get x. X dx becomes x square by 2. Right, guys? So what's the final answer be? Come on, tell me the final answer.
0, sir.
Yes,
sir. No. Guys. When I say d ln x moves from minus 1 to 1. Okay. I missed that out. Okay. Ln x moves from minus 1 to 1. So what is the value of x there? X will be e power minus 1. X will be e here. Understood? This is the critical part here. Okay. X will be e power minus 1. X will be e. So you're going from e power minus 1 to e. Okay. So you get e square by 2 minus 1 by 2 e square. This will be your answer. Understood? When I say d ln x, this variable is what moves from minus 1 to 1. Okay. Ln x. Okay. Okay, any doubts here, guys?
No, sir.
Okay. Let's just move ahead. The next question. Minus 1 to 1. D by dx of 1 by 1 plus e power 1 by x. Okay. Finally, do those questions. Come on. So, whenever you have some integral d by dx, f of x into dx, basically what happens is you are integrating d f of x. Okay. So, you'll get this as f of x directly. Okay, guys. This much is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. But then here, there is a slight problem. Can you find that out? Right? So when you apply the same thing here, f of x becomes 1 by 1 plus e power 1 by x from minus 1 to 1. It becomes 1 by 1 plus e minus 1 plus e power minus 1, which is 1 by e. That becomes
1. Then you should apply that 1 by 1 plus e. E 1 by x equal to minus 1, then find x from that. Like we did in the previous.
No. Like, that is what I did here, basically. I got it as 1 by 1 minus e by 1 plus e. But the problem is, this comes out to be wrong. And there is a reason why. Can you tell me what the reason is? Thing is, integration is applicable for like continuous functions. If you look at 1 by 1 plus 1 by x, at x equal to 0, this becomes discontinuous. All right? Okay. So, at x equal to 0, this becomes discontinuous. So what happens here is that you will have to split it into two parts. This one here should actually be split into two parts here. 1 by 1 plus e power 1 by x should go from minus 1 to 0, negative, plus 1 by 1 plus e power 1 by x should go from 0 positive to 1. Understood? Since it's discontinuous at 0, you have to break it into two parts. Then you should get the correct answer. What will happen here now? You get this as one plus e power minus infinity, right? First part, like 1 by 0 minus becomes minus infinity, and then minus 1 plus e power minus 1. So that can be written as e plus 1 divided. Okay, and then e on top. Plus second part, 1 by 1 plus e minus 1 by 1 plus e power infinity. This is 0 plus. So this is the difference that's causing the issue. Okay. So here, e power minus infinity is 0. Okay, so you get this as 1. Minus e by 1 plus e is there. Okay. Plus 1 by 1 plus e is there. Minus, what is this? This is 0. You get your final answer as 1 plus 1 minus e by 1 plus e. That can be written as 2 by 1 plus e. This becomes your final answer. Understood what you should be careful of? When you're integrating something, you have to check where it is continuous. All right. So that is the part you'll have to be careful of. So the safest thing is the second you find something is discontinuous. You see 0 is in between minus 1 and 1. And I see 1 by x. I'm expecting a discontinuity. So the safest bet is break it down into two parts. All right. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So just be careful of that. And then, so I'll give you another similar question, but practice this later. Number 1, d by dx, tan inverse 1 by x. Now it will seem obvious to you, okay, what to do. Just take care of this later. Okay, so next comes periodic properties. We're looking for periodic properties now. So, from 0 to nt f of x dx can be written as n into 0 to t f of x dx. You know what t is, right? The period of the function f of x. So suppose some function is periodic like this, greatest integer function, sorry, fractional part function, you know this is periodic. Okay, so you will be integrating something like fraction part of x from 0 to 10. So what you can do here is, instead of finding out the different graphs here, x, this is x minus 1, this is x minus 2, this is x minus 3, all the way up to x minus 9. Okay. So, instead of doing all that, you can just write this as 10 times 0 to 1. Okay, because the periodicity here, you can see the length of the period is 1 here. Okay, so you use 1 here, 10 times of, and rest you can figure it out. Got it? This is the basic periodic property I'm talking about. Okay, guys? This is for periodic functions. Okay. Also, for a periodic function f of x, for x dx, from a to a plus t will come out to 0 to t f of x dx. Okay. So basically, you have another periodic function. Okay. So you can see this is the value of t here. So if you are asked to integrate from a to a plus t, you're asked to find this integral here, right? But this integral here is the same as this area here. Got this? Because the length here is t, it is periodic. Okay. All right. So this length and then this area will be the same. So might as well just find the area from 0 to t, right? That's the idea. Guys, are you following or not? I don't hear anything.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, graph A to A plus NT. What do you do here? You tell me. This will be same as 0 to NT, right? F of x dx. Now, you can write that as N into 0 to T F of x dx. This is the property. Okay, both these points. Much should be clear to you if the previous part was clear to you. Now, if you're going from MT to NT F of x dx, we'll write this as N minus M 0 to T F of x dx. And all is obvious. All right. Now, I'll give you some questions to take back and practice. Yeah, 0 to 10, x minus f of x dx. Understand that the answer here will be 5. This is for a cross-checking, okay? 0 to 100, e power x minus f of x dx. And the answer here will be 100 into e minus 1. 0 to 400 pi root of 1 minus cos 2x dx. Answer here will be 800 root 2. Okay, please practice them. Please practice them. Try to get to the answer. Next comes Leibniz rule, inequalities, and definite integrals as sum of limits. So, yeah, we'll do that along with what's the thing called area under a curve in the next chapter. Okay, in the next class. It's in the class right now. But please, guys, practice the problems I'm giving you. Use every 15 minutes you can get to find. Like, find some time to solve a couple of problems and do it. Have you started doing mock tests, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
How are your scores? How are your scores? Please tell me. Like, it might be embarrassing. That's okay. Just tell me your scores. Like, how bad are they? That's what I'm asking. How bad are they?
I'm getting 100.
100 out of 300?
110 or something.
Okay. That has to improve. Keep giving mock tests. Are you noting your mistakes down and are you working on them? Varun?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Please spend, like, it's not about number of mock tests you do. It is there, but that is in the long term. Okay. Each mock test, build the quality of the mock test by, you know, finding out your mistakes, finding out where you went wrong, how you went wrong. Be aware of those mistakes. That's the only game here. Okay. Lakshanya, what about you?
Sir, I got 150 out of
300. 150. Okay. That is also needing improvement. Okay. But did you write physics and chemistry?
No, sir. I did the paper 2.
Huh?
I did the JE paper 2, sir. Not the JE paper 1.
Okay. So, how much is required for that?
For that, we have maths, we have aptitude, and we have architectural related drawing.
Like, what you want to do, like the stream you want to take in the college you want, sir. What is the cutoff mark for that roughly? Do you have any idea?
No, sir. I have to do that research.
Just Google that once, okay? You'll get that in 2 minutes. Okay. So, then you'll have an idea of target. The target should be there. Varun, I think your target should be around 170 to 200. And I think you can reach that because how is your physics and chemistry, da?
Sir, okay, sir. Maths on the overload question, I'll be able to realize like how to do it. Physics on the take some time.
Okay. Like in your exam, please finish chemistry off the fastest, okay? If possible, less than 45 minutes. The remaining 15 minutes will be there, right? From the chemistry part. You have to allocate it to physics or maths, depending on which is tougher.
Only organic, over? Only I have to study.
Organic?
Only I have to study organic, sir. Like physical chemistry, I'll easily do it. Inorganic also, I'll do it. Only organic.
Organic is the main weightage. Okay.
Sir, organic also only 35% of chemistry.
Which is like solid marks. Like organic is like this, man. You know it or you don't know it. So if you know it, it's free marks. Okay. So that's okay. That's okay. Like you have your own style of preparation. Like I'm talking if I were in your position that way. Okay. But you'll have your own style of preparation. Stick to that really. But yeah. Try to do this time management stuff. It is serious. Okay, guys. Because at the end, you can correct your silly mistakes also, and that will just boost your marks. Okay. We all make silly mistakes. That is the main issue, frankly. You do more mock tests, the chance of doing silly mistakes just drastically reduces. Okay. So, yeah. Practice, and then I'll see you in next class. Okay, guys? If you have any doubts, please ask now. Otherwise, yeah, class is done.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, take care.